like I belong.
The appeal is obvious, really, when you think about it. Driving a convertible, top down, even in the middle of a hopeless British summer, really does bring a ray of sunshine to a rainy day. I mean, take this Fiat Punto. Costs £13,000, it's in insurance group 9, does 36 miles to the gallon, has four seats and a usable boot. It's a sensible little car. But if you crank the radio up, get the roof down and bury your foot in the carpet, it becomes a 106 mile an hour roller coaster. You touch me in the dark. But maybe you're a bit of a traditionalist at heart, in which case I'm sure you'll be more tempted by this. The car that started it all, the Volkswagen Cabrio. This is the latest version, which, like the Punto, costs £13,000. But there's no central locking. There's no electric hood facility. There's no electric windows. I'm amazed it doesn't come with a starting handle. There are better equipped and faster models which can rattle along at 120 miles an hour. No, rattle is the wrong word. The one thing the Volkswagen Cabrio does not do is rattle. Of all the cars of this ilk, it feels the most together. And the slowest. If you don't fancy being left at the lights by a silver cross, there's now a new and massively improved version of the ragtop Escort. In the days when this was called the XR3i, it was pretty horrid. But it now has a 16-valve engine, a £16,000 price tag, and it's really rather good. But don't think Ford has forgotten its old customer base. You now get white dials to match your socks. Which is why my favourite of all the small contenders is this. It's the Peugeot 306 convertible, which has a Mercedes-style powered hood. No rollover bar either, so when the canvas is stowed in its neat little cubby there, the car adopts a low, sleek, slithery profile. The trouble is, there's a price to pay for this glorious Pininfarina styling. This car costs £18,000, and that, no matter how you look at it, is a lot. In Peugeot's defence, you get a 2-litre engine, an ability to do 120 miles an hour, anti-lock brakes, and every conceivable toy. That hood isn't the only thing that moves about electrically. You also get quite the most stupid piece of wood I've ever seen in any car ever before. But you tend to forget about that, and the slight lack of rigidity, and even the price, the first time you go round a corner.
All Peugeots handle better than all their competitors, and this is no exception. It feels like a sports car, it looks like a sports car, and when you bear that in mind, 18 grand seems okay. But what if £18,000 is the sort of money you lose down the back of the sofa? What are your choices? Well, two of the most recent entries come from Saab and Toyota. You get a choice of engines in the Saab and therefore a choice of prices. This is the cheapest with a 2-litre engine and a tag of just under £21,000.
That's not bad value when you remember that this is a big, prestigious car which, even in cheapo mode like this, has leather, an electric hood, a great stereo, and even a little light on the dashboard which is currently telling me that the airbag is either not working or about to go off of its own accord. But even though I'm likely to be punched in the face any minute, I do like this car. It should be able to give the BMW 3 Series convertible a run for its money, even if it can't quite match the style of the dynamo Audi. I also like this Toyota, but then that's hardly surprising. I do tend to have a soft spot for £28,000 convertibles that can nudge 140.
I must confess that I was expecting this car to be a bit of a barge. but it just isn't. It corners with the tenacity of a terrier. It bounces. It's loud. It's alive. You might even call it a bit rough and ready.
There is, however, nothing that's even remotely rough and ready about its hood.
Like all the cars here, it fits beautifully. There are no drafts and no leaks. In this sector of the market, you should expect a heated glass rear window, which Volkswagen does give you, and electric operation, which they don't. What I'm trying to say here is this. All these cars can, when the need arises, be as weatherproof as their hardtop alternatives.
So, which one of these cars would I buy? Well, the Fiat's got lots of character, the Ford's much improved, the Peugeot is lovely. But the answer is none of them. You see, the trouble is that all these cars were originally designed to be either coupes or convertibles, and that means the front and the back were supposed to be joined by two pieces of metal, the floor and the roof. Now, if you take the roof away, you either have to add a ton of underfloor strengthening, which makes the car feel wooden, or you let it flop around like one of Bugs Bunny's ears, which makes it feel absolutely horrible.
The solution is to buy a car that was designed from day one as a soft top. And in the next few months, you are going to be bombarded with a torrent of proper, purpose-built convertibles. For a kickoff, there's the new MG.
Why buy one of these halfway houses when the real thing is just around the corner? Funny, isn't it? The environmentalists and the politicians have done their best to take the fun out of motoring. Now, the car manufacturers are about to put it back.